Dear students, today we will study the we'll solve the problems on the parabola, the ellipse and the hyperbola. The parabola, ellipse and the hyperbola to CET JE mains JE level. To CET JE level, especially the JE questions will be covered here. Okay. So look at the first question. Before going to the solving problems, let's recall the concepts, the definitions, the formulas involved in the parabola, ellipse and hyperbola. Okay. So yesterday we briefly studied the formulas, the related information about the parabola, ellipse and hyperbola in the last class, that is synopsis. So today we'll solve the problems. So the first one is, the focus of the parabola is, what is the parabola given? The parabola is given to be y square equals to 4ax. So remember that for any parabola y square equals to 4ax, whose okay, so always the focus is at the point a comma 0. This is just default by the definition of the parabola, right? So that the focus is always at the point a comma 0. Therefore, the option number 1, option number C is your right answer. Okay, so let's go to the second question. Moving on the second question. The vertex of the parabola, if the vertex of the parabola is at the origin and the directrix is x plus 5 equals to 0. So what is this x plus 5 equals 0? The x plus 5 equals to 0 leads to x equals to minus 5. Right? The x plus 5 equals 0 leads to x equals to minus 5, right? Therefore, x equals to minus 5 is nothing but the directrix which is at the negative x dash axis. So this is the minus 5 distance towards the negative x axis. Therefore, this line is x dash equals to minus 5, or I can say x equals to minus 5, right? So this line is, it means the parabola is having the opening towards the positive x-axis. Okay, so what he is asking, if the vertex of the parabola is at the origin, if this is the origin, this point is origin, 0, 0, 0, then what he is asking, then the latest rectum is asking. What is the latest rectum? The latest rectum is always 4a, right? Therefore, here, what is the academic definition? What is that? X equals to minus a is, the directrix. So, what is the value of a here? A is 5. A value is 5. Substitute here, you get 4 into 5, which is 20, The option is, your answer is the option number C, which is 20. Because we got the value of a here through this directrix. Therefore, the directrix has x equals to minus a, a value is 5, so 4 into 5 is 20, 4, 5 is 20, option number 2 is the right answer. So, let's go to the third question. The latest rectum of the parabola whose directrix is x plus y equals to 2, and focus is 3, minus 4. Okay, look at this. If the directrix is given to be x plus y minus 2 equals 0 and focus is 3, minus 4, then we have to find the distance between the directrix and is nothing but what is given here, that is the focus is at the point some point h comma k, so h plus k comma so x plus k plus this constant c, that is 3 minus 4 and minus 2, divided by square root of this 2. So what is the value we're going to get? We're going to get plus or minus 3 by root 2. So plus or minus 3 by root 2. So after that, what is the latest rectum? The latest rectum is no doubt 3 root 2. The latest rectum is 3 root 2. Okay. So since the latest rectum has 2 times the distance, so 2 times the distance means actually if you consider this 2 times this distance, 2 times the distance means 3 divided by root 2 into 2 times, 2 times that leads to 3 root 2, that leads to 3 root 2, which is your option number B is the right answer. Moving on, question number 4, the end points of the latest rectum of the parabola, x square equals to 4ay, so this is the type of the parabola, okay, so this is the type of the parabola, and we have to find the ends of the latest rectum, this point as well as this point. So what is the axis of the parabola? The axis of the parabola is no doubt y-axis, the axis of the parabola is no doubt y-axis, so therefore, what are the points? So by definition, what is the distance? From here to here, what is the distance we have to find? And from here to here, what is the distance we have to find? So by the definition, what is the answer? The x distance is 2a and the y distance is a. It means the option number D is your answer. This is just by, if you know the formula, then the ends points of the latest rectum is minus a comma 2a, and that is minus a comma minus 2a comma a and 2a comma a. This point is minus 2a comma a, and this point is nothing but 2a comma a. Therefore, the D is your right answer. D is your right answer. Answer is option number D is your right answer. Okay. Moving on. Question number 5. If the parabola y square equals to 4x is passing through the 3 comma minus 3 comma 2, then length of the latest rectum. So what is this y square equals to 4x? The nature of the parabola is like this. This is y square equals to 4x. Right, so y square equals to 4ax is this parabola. Okay, so this parabola is y square equals to 4ax, and somewhere point is given to be this point. This point is minus 3 comma 2. It means in this formula, substitute x equals to minus 3 and y equals to 2. Do that. Y square equals to 4ax. Substitute x equals to minus 3, y equals to 2. What you are going to get? So minus this is 2 square equals to 4 into minus 2 times a. So what is that? 4 equals to 4 into minus 2 into a. So 4 get cancelled. A equals to minus 1 by 2. A equals to minus 1 by 2. So what we got? A equals to minus 1 by 2. Use this minus 1 by 2. Okay. Use this minus 1 by 2. Put x equals to minus 3 and y equals to, okay. So put x equals to minus 3 and y equals to 2 here. So if you put a y equals to 2, 2 to the 4, 4 as it is x equals to minus 3. So minus 3 times a. So 4 get cancelled. 4 get cancelled here. 4 get cancelled. So what is left? A equals to minus 1 by 3. A equals to minus 1 by 3 is left here. A equals to minus 1 by 3 left. So minus 1 by 3 left. So what is the length of the latest rectum? The length of latest rectum is always 4a for any parabola. 4 times minus 1 by 3 is minus 4 by 3. But as the a is always positive, therefore take plus a by 3 plus 1 by 3. What is your answer? Option number B. Option number B is your right answer. Option number B is your right answer. Question number 6. If the equation, the parabola with its vertex at the origin, on the x-axis, y-axis, passing through the point 6, minus 3. Okay? So what is the axis of the parabola? The axis of the parabola is y-axis. It means the parabola nature is like this. This is the parabola whose axis is y-axis. Passing through 6, any point you can take. This point is 6, minus 3. It means the parabola equation has to be substituted x equals to 6 and y equals to minus 3. So what is that nature? The nature of the parabola is x square equals to 4ay, substitute x equals to 6, y equals to minus 3, substitute x equals to 6 and y equals to minus 3. What you are going to get? So x 6 square equals to 4a into y is minus 3. So 36 is equals to 3, 4 is a minus 12, minus 12a, or I can say 12, 3 is a 36, minus 3, a equals to minus 3. It means the distance of the focus from the origin is, there is plus 3. The distance is always plus, therefore a equals to 3. What we obtained is a equals to 3 here, right? So what he is asking? Equation of the parabola he is asking. So what is the equation? Substitute x, a equals to, a is equals to minus 3 in the this equation. What you are going to get is x square equals to 4ay, and 4 as it is a value is minus 3 into y, so this is minus 12y. So as minus 12y is the answers obtained, then check it out which one is the appropriate option. The option is x square equals to minus 12y. Option number C is your right answer. Moving on. Question number 7. The focus and the directrix of the parabola x square equals to minus 8ay. So this is the negative y dash axis. And what is given? X square equals to minus 8ay. X square equals to 4 times minus 2a times y, isn't it? So minus 4 times minus 2 times y is minus 8y. It means what is the value of a? A is 2a here. So what is the focal length? That is the focus distance from the vertex is 2a. Okay. So what are your options? From the given options? Yes, tell me, anybody? What are the options? The options are, first option, what is the answer? The answer is option number A. Because as the 0, minus 2a is the foci, 0, minus 2a is the foci, the y equals to 2a, so here the directrix is y equals to 2a. The directrix is y equals to 2a. Therefore, option number A is your right answer. Okay, fine. Moving on. Question number 8. The equation of the parabola with the focus 3, 0 and the directrix x equals to minus 3. The directrix is x equals to minus 3. Definitely the directrix is s in the x dash axis. This is x equals to minus 3. Okay, fine. Then focus is given to be 3, 0. This is 3, 0. Okay. Then what is the equation of the parabola? The value of a is already given. A equals to 3 is given. So from the given data, a is 3 already. Therefore, y square equals to 4ax. Therefore, 4 times a is 3, x as d is 12x, therefore y square equals to 12x is your answer. Option number, what is that? Option number C is your answer. Option number C is your answer. Option number C is your right answer. Okay. Moving on. Question number 9. The point on the parabola y square equals to 12x, whose focal distance is 4. So y square equals to 12x is the given parabola. This is the parabola 12x, where 3 is the distance of the focus from the vertex, and the focal distance is 4. The focal distance is 4 given. Okay. Then what is your answer? Okay. So as a is 3 here, note down, as a is 3 here, the abscissa is, what is that, 4 minus 3 is 1. 4 minus 3 is 1. It means y square equals to what? 12. Y square is 12 given. Then what is the value of y? That implies, what is the value of y? Y is plus or minus 2 root 3. Okay? Plus or minus 2 root 3. It means what is your option? Your options are 1 comma plus or minus 2 root 3. That is 1 comma 2 root 3 and 1 comma minus 2 root 3. Okay? So 1 comma 2 root 3 and 1 comma, this is 1 value, this is 2 root 3. 1 comma 2 root 3 and 1 comma minus 2 root 3 is your right answer. Option number B. Question number 10. The parabola passing through the point 4 comma minus 2 has its vertex at the origin and the axis is y axis. Okay, it means this type of the parabola it is. This is a parabola passing through minus 4 comma 2. So there are some any point, minus 4 comma 2 is any point in the parabola, right? The axis is y axis. Then the latest rectum of the parabola is asking. So what is the nature of the parabola? Nature of the parabola is x square equals to 4ay and passing through minus 4 comma minus 2. Substitute x equals to minus 4, y equals to minus 2. So x value is minus 4 whole square, and 4 times a as it is, the y value is minus 2. So what is the answer here? 16 equals to minus 8a, or I can say a equals to minus 2. So what is this a equals to minus 2? The focal distance is 2, right? The directrix is x equals to, that is y equals to minus 2, right? Therefore, so a equals to minus 2 we obtained. So as a equals to minus 2 is obtained, so what is the latest rectum? The length of the latest rectum is always 4a for any parabola. 4 times has to take this positive 2, which is 8. The right answer is option number B. Option number B is your right answer. Okay, moving on. Question number 11. The focus of the parabola x square equals to minus 16y is 4 times minus 4. That is minus 4. 4 times minus 4. Y. So what is this? Negative point is there. So x square equals to minus 4ay. It means the value, the focus, the distance of the focus in the vertex is minus 4. So what is your answer? Answer is the any point which lies on y axis. It means like this. You can observe. So this point is 0 comma minus 4. So 0 comma minus 4. Option number 4 is the right answer. Option number 4 is the right answer. So moving on. If the distance between the directrices be thrice the distance between the foci, right? If the distance between the directrices is thrice the distance between the foci, then what to take? What is the distance between the directrices? 2b by, that is 2a by e. 2a by e. Okay? So what is the distance? 2a by e is what? Twice, three times, right? Three times 2a. It means 2a by e equals to 6ae. 6a, that leads to cancel the a's, cancel the a's, and a get cancelled. E square equals to 1 by, that is 2 by 6, which is e equals to plus or minus 1 by root 3, right? E equals to plus or minus 1 by root 3. Plus or minus 1 by root 3. So what is the answer? The answer is option number C. Option number C, plus or minus 1 by root 3. 1 by root 3 is given, option number. Okay, option number this is your right answer. Okay, fine. Moving on. We'll go to some part of the ellipse, because as this contains the parabola, ellipse and hyperbola 3, therefore we'll go to the ellipse. The equation of the ellipse whose center is at the origin, passing through the points minus 3, 1 and 2, minus 2. There are two points given to be minus 3, 1 and 2, that is the ellipse is passing through, right? The ellipse is passing through. So this ellipse is passing through two points. There are two points given on the ellipse. And what is asking? The center is at the origin. No doubt this is the origin. Alright? No doubt this is the origin. Therefore, how to use this? So what is the equation of the ellipse? X square by a square plus y square by b square equals to 1. In this equation, substituting x equals to minus 3 and y equals to 1, you get the one equation. Substituting x equals to 2 and minus 2, you get the another equation. And when you solve these two equations, right, what you are going to get? You are going to get a square equals to 32 by 3 and 32 by 3 and b square equals to, what you are going to get? 32 by 5 you are going to get. And so if you substitute, the final answer will be 3x square plus 5y square plus 5y square equals to 32. And if you observe this, if you cross examine this, definitely the required equation of the ellipse is passing through these points. It means, what is your answer? 3x square plus 5y square equals to 32, the option number B is your right answer. The thing is, you have to solve these equations by substituting once. If you substitute the x equals to minus 3 and y equals to 1 in this equation, you are going to get the value of A or B. And once one you substitute the x value to y value minus 2, you are going to get the B square value. And when you substitute both the B square, A square and B's and A's, you are going to get the option B, which is the right answer. Question number 14. The foci and the vertices of an ellipse are given to be plus or minus 1 comma 0, plus or minus 2 comma 0. So looking at the point, any point which lies on the x-axis is always of the form x comma 0, maybe plus or minus sometimes. It means what? That definitely ellipse has a major axis, x-axis, right? The ellipse has a major axis, x-axis. What it indicates? It indicates that looking at the point minus plus or minus 1 comma 0, the ellipse of the major axis is definitely the x-axis. Then the minor axis of the ellipse is, that is, he's asking about length of the minor axis. So length of the minor axis. Okay. So let us calculate this one. So the length of the minor axis. So what is given here? The plus or minus 1 is given. So what is that? A into E equals to 1. Then what is the value of E? E value is 1 by 2. If you resubstitute this E value, what do you get the value of A? You get the value of A to be 2. Right? Okay, because 2 into 1 by 2 is 1. Now, the formula is v equals to root of, what is the formula? Root of, that is 4 times 1 minus 1 by 4. Okay, if you substitute these, so 1 minus, that is root of e into 1 minus 1 by a square. So you, what you get, you solve this, root 3 you are going to get. Root 3, you are going to get the root 3. So the minor axis is, the minor axis is 2 root 3, because 2 times the b value, 2b, which is 2 root 3. Therefore, your answer is option number D. Option number D is your right answer. Option number D is your right answer. Okay. Moving on. The equation of the direct axis of the ellipse 16x square plus 25y square equals to 400 r. Okay, let us do that. So let us solve this one. 16x square plus 25y square equals to 400. Divide both sides by 400, what you are going to get? So x square, x square by 25 plus y square by 16 equals to what? 400 by 400 is 1. You are going to get this, right? So no doubt here, I think the first option, second option, third options are not matching. Okay, they will not match. Okay, find the direct axis here. So what is the, what are the direct axis? The direct axis are x plus or minus 5 divided by 3 by 5. The x plus or minus, oh sorry, divided by, that is, if you re-simplify this, what are you going to get? 3x plus or minus 25 equals to 0. It means it is not present in any of the options. You look at the options. Look at the options. The options not containing this equation. This equation. Therefore, none of these is your answer. None of these is your answer. Next, moving on. The eccentricity of an ellipse is 2 by 3. The length, that is E equals to 2 by 3 is given. E equals to 2 by 3 is given. The latest rectum is 5. The latest rectum is 5. Right? Is 5. The center is 0, 0. That is at the origin. Then the equation of the ellipse is as the center is at the origin and the eccentricity is 2 by 3. Eccentricity is 2 by 3. S, how to solve this? Okay, what is given? So what is the eccentricity? E square equals to 1 minus b by a whole square. Use this formula. Substitute e value. Right? Substitute the e value. So what is that? 2 by 3 whole square equals to 1 minus b by a whole square. Right? 1 minus b by a whole square. 1 minus b by a whole square. B by a whole square. Okay. So what you are going to get? If you solve this, you are going to get 2b square by a equals to 5. Or when you simplify this, you get a equals to 81 by 4 and b equals to 45 by 4. So when you simplify these equations, right? You simplify these equations, you are going to get a equals to 81 by 4 and b equals to 45 by 4. And if you further re-substitute these values in the given, look at the option. Option A is not matching with this. Option B is matching with this. I think option B is matching this. The right answer. If you substitute in place of x square by a square, if you substitute here 81 by 4, that become 4 by 81. And 45 by 4 is 4 by 45. Therefore, your answer is option number B is your answer. Option number B is your answer. Moving on, the distance between the direct axis of the ellipse. The distance between the direct axis of the ellipse. X square by 36 plus y square by 20 equals to 1 is. S. What is given here? A square is 36. What it indicates is plus or minus 6. B square is 20. 20, it means B is plus or minus s 2 root 5. We have a and b values in the given equation of the ellipse. Then how x equals to, what is that? X equals to plus or minus a by e. That is 2 times. Therefore, the distance between them, the distance between them is 2 times 6 into 2 divided by 2 into, that is 2 by 3. 2 by 3. So what are you going to get? You are going to get, first you have to find the b value. Before this, you have to find the b value. So what is the b value? Okay. So b value is, okay. So eccentricity you have to find. We have a value and b value. You have to find e. What is the formula for e? That is root of s, root of What you are going to get? 2 by 3. Okay, I will write this once again. You can see. Right? Okay. So, what is the formula? B square equals to A square into 1 minus E square. Right? That leads to that leads to again leads to e equals to root of 16 divided by, right, again that is equals to, oh, so what we are going to get? 20 divided by 36. Okay, so 1 minus e square, that implies, so this is equals to 1 minus e square. We already wrote here. Okay, so already wrote here. So what you are going to get? So further what you are going to get? So 1 minus e square is 20 by 36. E square is 20 by 36 plus 1. So you will get root of 16 by 36, which is 4 by, which is, that is 4 by 6, which is 2 by 3. We have a value of E equals to 2 by 3. Then, what is the answer? Your answer is the distance between them, the distance between the direct traces, the distance between the direct traces is, the distance between the direct traces is 2 times A divided by, 2 times A divided by this one, E. A by E. So what are you going to do? 2 times 6 divided by 2 by 3. So what is your answer? Your answer is 18. Your answer is 18. If you solve this, 2 to get cancelled, 6 is 18. So 18 is your right answer. 18 is your right answer. I recall this again. We have values of A and B. Calculate the value of E and substitute in this D equals to 2 times A divided by E. You are going to get the 18. So 18 is your right answer. 18 is your right answer. Option number C is your right answer. Option number C is your right answer. Okay, moving on. The next question is, the length of the latest rectum of the ellipse, pi x square plus 9y square equals to 45 is, we have to find the length of the latest rectum. Okay, so when you simplify this, what you are going to get? You are going to get this equation become x square by 9 plus y square by 5 equals to 1. Okay, so what is the length of the latest rectum? The length of the latest rectum of the given ellipse will be 2 times b square by a. We already know this. So 2 times b square by a is nothing but 2 times, what is the value of a here? A values and b values are written here. 2 times b square by a. So 2 times b square by a. So 2 times 5 by 3. 2 times 5 is by 3. What is your answer? Your answer is 10 by 3. 10 by 3. What is your answer option then? Then the right option will be, the right answer in the given options will be 10 by 3, option number D. Option number D is your right answer. Question number 19. Question number 19. So what is the question number 19? The distance between the foci of the ellipse 3x square plus 4y square equals to 48 is. So when you write this neatly, what you are going to get? You are going to get x square by 48 by 3, x square by, I write here, x square by 48 by 3 and y square plus y square by 48 by 4 equals to 1, because it is not the 4 and 3 are not the factors of 48, right? So moving on, so what is the a square here? What is the a square given? The a square is given to be 16 here, right? So b square is given to be 12, right? A square is, if you simplify this, the A square and B square are available here. That is, if you further simplify this, you are going to get 16, which is A square, and B square is, that is 48 by 4 is 12 equals to 1. So A square is 16, B square is 12, right? So what is the eccentricity? E equals to root of 1 minus B square by A square. 1 minus b square by a square. Substitute the b's and a values. These values here. So b square is 12, c square and a square is 16. When you solve this, you are going to get 1 by 2. You are going to get 1 by 2. And the distance, it is asking the distance. So the distance is 2 times ae. The distance is 2 times ae. Therefore, 2 into 4 into 1 by 2, 2 into 4 into 1 by 2, therefore what is your answer? Your answer is again 4, option number B is your right answer, option number B is your right answer. So the question number 20, if the eccentricity of the hyperbola is, if the eccentricity of the hyperbola is
1 by a square minus y square by b square equals to 1 and x square by b square minus x, y square by b square minus x square by b, a square equals to 1 is e and a 1, then 1 by 1 plus e square plus e 1 square is, he's asking. So what is the formula eccentricity? Eccentricity is root of 1 plus b square by a square. We know that. Root of 1 plus b square by a square. So if you take e square for this, what you are going to get? You are going to get a square plus b square by a square again. Okay, this is the known formula. This is the known formula, already we know. So this is the e square value. So what is e1 square? What is e1 square? So e1 square is root of 1 plus a square by b square, right, which will be again a square plus b square by b square. So 1, then what is given? What is the given is 1 by e square plus 1 by e1 square is asking. So 1 by e square means this and e1 square has to be taken here. So 1 by e square and e1 square, use this and this value to substitute here in the given, 1 by e square plus 1 by e1 square, what you are going to get? You are going to get 1, 100% when you substitute these two. When you substitute these two values in this, you are going to get the 1. So 1 by e square plus 1 by e1 square is 1. Option number 1 is your right answer. Option number 1 is your right answer. Option number 1 is your right answer. Okay. Option number 1 is your right answer. That is 1 is your answer. Moving on. Next we will solve some problems in the hyperbola. Okay. So hyperbola. So if the latest symptom of an hyperbola is 8 and the eccentricity is 3. Right? If the latest symptom of the hyperbola is 8 and eccentricity is 3, hyperbola, the latest symptom is 8, eccentricity is 3. So what are the given? The latest symptom. The latest symptom is 2b square by a is 8. The 2b square by a is 8. And eccentricity is given. Eccentricity is 3 given. So 3 by root 5. So 3 by root 5 is equals to root of, what is that? 1 plus b square by a square. B square by a square is the formula. So when you compare these values, so what you are going to get? 4 by 5 is equals to b square by a square. B square by a square. Or for example, you are going to get a equals to 5 and b equals to 2 root 5. A equals to 5 and b equals to 2 root 5. Okay. So as the a equals to 5 and b equals to 2 root 5, then the required hyperbola is, what is that? Option number A. Because what you are going to get? X square by 25 minus y square by 20. Okay, so x square by 25 minus y square by 20 is equals to 100. So which leads to the first option, therefore first option is your right answer. The question 22. The one which does not represent the hyperbola is, which one is not the hyperbola? Look at the first one. X into y equals to 1 represents the hyperbola. X square minus y square equals to 5 represents hyperbola. And I think the option number D is the right answer. X square minus y square equals to 0 is not representing hyperbola, because what is the condition? Yes. What is the condition? The condition that the delta should not be equals to 0. Right? Look at this. This is 0. The delta should not be equals to 0. But the last option is given to be 0. Therefore, the delta should not be equals to 0. And the h square must be more than ab. So this is the condition with which the x square minus y square equals to 0. Okay? So as this is given to be 0, delta is equals to 0. So right, the last answer is not an hyperbola. This is not an hyperbola. So 23. Look at the 23. The length of the transverse axis of the hyperbola is 7. And it passes through the point 5, -2. Then the equation of the hyperbola is. Okay. So as the point is given here, 5, -2, substitute x equals to 5 and y equals to -2 in the standard equation of the hyperbola. So in this you are going to get 7 by 2. And as you substitute the x equals to 5 and y equals to -2, you are going to get from this equation, what you are going to get? A square is 49 by 4. And A is 7 by 2 already, right? A is 7 by 2. And we need to find the value of B square, okay? Therefore, 4 times, okay? So, if you substitute these values, so what you are going to get? You are going to get 4 times 49 into 25 minus 51 divided by 196 times the 40 the fourth, which is equals to 1. That leads to the, okay, when you substitute this, we are going to get this. So what is your right answer? Your answer is option number C. Option number C is your right answer. So what are given? The length of the transverse axis is given, 2a equals to 7. Passing through the point 5 comma minus 2, it means you have to substitute, x square by a square minus y square by b square. So here x square and y square are substituted. So and what are the values of the a and b? The a value you're going to get is 7 by 2. Therefore your your answer is 4 by 49 x square minus 51 by 196 y square equals to 1, because this is satisfied by the point 5 comma minus 2. This has the transverse axis length is 7. There is no another answer which is matching the, which is fitting these two parameters. Therefore option number C is the most appropriate and exact answer is option number C. Option number C has passing through this 5 comma minus 2. The hyperbola C has the transverse axis length 7. There is no another hyperbola which has a transverse axis 7 and passing through 5 comma minus 2. Okay, so moving on. Question number 24. If 4 comma 0 and minus 4 comma 0 be the vertices and 6 comma 0 and minus 6 comma 0 be the foci of the hyperbola, then the eccentricity is, so what are the value of A here? A value is definitely 4. Okay, so what are the foci? Foci is plus or minus 6 comma 0. It means what you are going to get? A into E equals to 6. It means substituting A equals to 6, 4 value here. So 4E equals to 6. So E equals to 6 by 4, which is 3 by 2. E equals to 3 by 2. 3 by 2 is your right answer. Option number C is your right answer. Next, example number 25. The eccentricity of the hyperbola x square minus y square equals to 25 is s in area. The eccentricity of the hyperbola x square by, rewrite this equation, x square by 25 minus y square by 25 equals to 1. Divide both sides by 25. What are you going to get? X square by 25 minus y square by 25 equals to 1. So what is the eccentricity? Eccentricity is root of 2. Root of 2. Where a equals to b is the situation. A equals to b is the condition here, that here a square and b square are same. Implies a equals to b. Whenever a equals to b, then the eccentricity is root 2. What is your option? Your option is, answer is option number 2. Option number a is your answer. Okay. A is your answer. Option number A is your answer, which is root. So 26th. The eccentricity of the conic 16x square. The eccentricity of the conic 16x square plus 7y square equals to 112 is. Rewrite this equation. What are you going to get? X square. What are you going to get? You are going to get x square by 112 by 16 minus, that is plus y square by 112 by 7 equals to 1. It means the eccentricity is root of, as the same formula, 1 minus 112 by 16 into 7 by 112. So what you are going to get? Solve this. You are going to get 9 by 16. You are going to get 3 by 4. Your right answer is option number C is your right answer. Okay, so moving on. Question number 27. If the distance between the foci of an ellipse be equal to the minor axis, okay, so there is an ellipse given and the distance between the foci and the minor axis both are equal. The distance between foci and the minor axis both are equal. And in that case, what to do? That is, you can observe here. You can observe here that the distance between the minor axis and the foci must be same. It means 2AE equals to 2B. Both are equal here. Both are equal here. Otherwise, if you cancel this, AE equals to B is there. AE equals to B is there. Then in this case, what is the formula? B square equals to S A square into 1 minus E square. 1 minus E square. So put B equals to AE. Put B equals to AE. What you are going to get? A square E square equals to A square into 1 minus E square. So your A square get cancelled. So what is left? What is left is E square equals to 1 minus E square. So 2E square equals to 1. E square equals to 1 by 2. Or I can say E equals to plus or minus 1 by root 2. I can say that plus or minus 1 by root 2. Plus or minus 1 by root 2 is the E. General I can take 1 by root 2. So what is the answer? Your answer is option number B. 28th one is, if the center, vertex and the focus of the hyperbola is 0, 0, 4, 0 and 6, 0 respectively. The center is C, 0, the focus is 4, 0 and the vertex is 4, 0, the focus is 6, 0. The focus is 6, 0. And in this case, how to solve the next? What is asking? Then the equation of the hyperbola is. He is asking the equation of the hyperbola. Okay. So let us squaring and subtracting. Okay. When you square and subtract, what you are getting? You are getting a square x square minus b square y square equals to a square minus b square. Okay. You can observe here. So what is the answer? The answer is option number last D. D is your answer. If you square and substitute these values, the center is not required. The vertex value A and the focus A and B value, when you substitute in this, you are definitely going to get the phi x square minus 4 y square equals to 8. Okay, so that is your hint to get this answer. It's a hint to get this answer. Question number 29. Okay, so this is somehow complicated, but I tell you the tricks how to do this. The equation of the hyperbola whose conjugate axis is 7, the distance between the foci is 30. Is okay, so conjugate axis distance is given, which is the 5, the distance between foci, what is given? Distance between foci is given to be 30, okay? That implies 2b equals to 5, 2b equals to 5, the conjugate axis length is 5, 2b equals to 5 is given. What is the value of b? B is 5 by 2, no doubt b is 5 by 2, and 2 times a, the 2 times A is 13. 2 times A is 13 we are going to get. Okay? Because this distance between foci is 13, 2 times A into E is 13 and 2B is 5. So what we got? We got the both values here, B value as well as the A, 2 times A, the distance between the foci. Okay? So when you substitute, the hint is B square equals to A square into E square minus 1. So in this, when you substitute the value of B, which is 5 by 2, and b square stands for 5 square by 2 square, okay, 5 square by 2 square equals to, if you substitute the value of 2ae, finally you are going to get a and b values here. You are going to get the a and b values. You are going to get the a and b values. Therefore, what you are going to get? You are going to get a and b values. The a and b values what you are obtained is a value 6 you will get and b value is 5/2 you will get. When you solve this, you are going to get a and b values. And further, which leads to the option number a. Option number a. 25x square minus 144y square equals to 900. Okay. When you substitute this, these values in this, you are going to get a and b value. You can just work out this, and the option number a is the right answer. Last question, question number 30. A hyperbola passes through the point 3, 2, minus 17, 12, and has a center. I just mark it out and I help you how to do this. You can mark out this in the form. So as the hyperbola is passing through 3, 2 and minus 17, 12, substitute x equals to 3 and y equals to 2 in the hyperbola equation and minus 17 and 12 in the hyperbola equation. And it has a center at the origin. Origin is at the center. Transverse axis is x axis is given. Then he is asking to find the length of the transverse axis. Length of the transverse axis. So the length of the transverse axis is 2 times a, which is 2 into 1, which is 2. Alright? So we are going to get the a value here by substituting these values. What you have obtained? You have obtained the a value 1, b value you will get to be 2. Root 2. Therefore, substituting a value equals to 1 here, we just work out this problem in the home. Okay. So in this session, we have completed the more problems on the parabola, ellipse as well as hyperbola. Okay. Thank you.